Hello. During this first week, you've heard a lot of sigla, a lot of acronyms, a lot of unfamiliar names. These names are about technologies which work together. And in this last module of the first week, we're going to explain how these technologies interact and how they are useful together in a kind of constellation, working to make the best of the XML source you will be encoding. So let's start. You have the source document. The source document is encoded in XML. The purpose of this document is to mark up your text, to describe the data in a semantic way, to describe it with tags, with elements, in a tree structure, and to mark up all the elements that will be useful in your edition later. You have great liberty in encoding this XML document. You can create new tags, you can create new elements, as long as they do not overlap. You have a lot of freedom in creating that. So to compensate this freedom, you have other technologies. Like, you know, when you're entering data into a database, you need some kind of form. Some kind of form that will help you put the right data in the right place. It's the same thing with XML. You have some data used to control the format of the data you're entering, and this is called schemas. Schemas provide rules that go beyond the simple do not overlap rule of the XML. And actually, the Text Encoding Initiative is a particular schema. There are other schemas, like, for instance, the EAD for finding aid and so on and so on. But the TI, the Text Encoding Initiative, is a particular schema created for text in the humanities. So it will provide rules. How can you use this or that element in respect with other elements? How many attributes can you have in this element? What is their name? What can be the contents? And so on and so on. Think about it as a database entry form, where you have, you know, control menus telling you that you have a set of values possible for this field. It's the same thing here. You have a set of, you know, lifeguards helping you have the same kind of encoding for the same kind of documents. Next technology in the constellation is the one helping you to display the documents. And here come into play the XSLT and CSS that Elena told you about in a previous module. So the simple CSS comes from the web. It can work either on HTML, on the web pages, or also on XML. And XSLT, as Elena told you, has more power. It has more features. And essentially, these technologies are used not only for just for displaying the documents. They are also used when it comes to XSLT, to transform the document from your XML source into something else. And most commonly, this other thing will be a web page. So you transform XML into HTML and you display it. But you can also use the XSLT programs to transform your form of XML, that is a non-TI XML, into something else in XML. So from one schema to another. That's also a very common use of XSLT. And of course, you can also convert XML into a totally non-XML format, something totally different, into plain text, into also traditional word processing document. DocX can be produced from XML. LibreOffice also can be produced from XML. So that's the idea of not only displaying with these technologies, but also transforming into something else. Finally, you will need to query your document, your XML document. And for this, you have the XPath and XQuery technologies. They are query languages which are both defined by the W3C recommendations. XQuery is the more complex and the more powerful of the two, but it's also the more difficult to use. And XPath, on the other hand, is much much more easier to use. And it its purpose is to select parts of the XML source. And typically, it's very much used in XSLT programs, where you are going to go and grab some data from your XML source to display it at a particular place in a web page, for instance. If you're interested in these particular technologies, XPath, XQuery, and so on, that's not something we are going to deal with during the main part of the MOOC, but you will have the opportunity to choose an additional module during the fifth week, dealing specifically with XSLT and including some XPath teaching also. So in this schema, you can see the representation of how this constellation of technology works. At the center, you have the XML source, the one you're going to learn how to encode, how to create during this MOOC. And around them, around those XML documents, you have the other technologies. So through the XSLT, you will have interactions through the end-user interfaces, displaying your edition in a nice way, and having interactions with the users and so on. Through the XQuery, XPath query language, let's say, you can have also interactions with the users, but also you can have software, third-party software with parsers that can query the data from your edition and use it in their own way for web services, for whatever purpose they can have. And behind all this, you have the schemas that ensure, that guarantee that the data you put in your XML documents is always the same, always conforms to the same structure, the same rules that have been defined by actually a scholarly community. It may seem a bit complicated, all these names, all these sigla at first hand, but remember that it all works together. Here you are going to learn about XML and the rule behind XML that deals with humanities text, that is the Text Encoding Initiative. You will also use CSS and XSLT that will provide to you, but you are not expected to learn that specifically unless you choose the final module. And with this ends your first week of this MOOC. Congratulations for reaching this point, and we hope you stick with us and enjoy the additional exercises.